And finally tonight, news of a real shortage, tyres. Here's a report from Frank Hayes.
I don't know whether you've heard the one about the motorist and his tyres, but it's a very old gag. You often hear it in garages. Motorist needed a new tyre, so he rang the garage, said, could you put me a new tyre on my car? Certainly, sir, they said. What kind is it? It's a blue one, he said. I know it's a corny gag, but it does contain a certain grain of truth. You see, most people in the tyre business believe that the average motorist's knowledge of tyres extends to the black, the round, and there's one at each corner. You don't believe it? Well, what sort of tyres does your car run on?
No, I've no idea. I haven't actually, no. I haven't the funkest idea.
I've got no idea, sorry.
Yeah, I've got all remolds.
No idea. I'm sorry, I don't know at all.
Crossbly.
Make?
Dunlop.
Sure?
Positive.
I've no idea, I only bought it a week ago.
Those motorists talking to Tony Bastable there would have had a totally different reply if they'd been through what I have in the past few weeks. This tyre was on my car until a couple of weeks ago when I had a 70 mile an hour blowout on the motorway. The result? This. You see the split? Well, there's absolutely no way that damage like that can be repaired, so I set off to buy a new tyre, and that's when I learnt about the national tyre shortage. I tried more than a dozen garages and none of them had a tyre of the right size. Until I came to this tyre depot in central London, and even at a big depot like this, they only had two. Roy Riley is a director of the firm that runs this garage, and he also looks after about 100 other tyre depots in the southeast. Roy, there are two classic reasons for shortages, striking and hoarding. Now, I know there haven't been any strikes in the tyre industry during the past year, and again, I've heard of hoarding petrol and sugar, but tyres, well, I can't believe it. So why do we have a shortage?
Well, I think, Frank, there are four main reasons. One is that we have had a demand to supply requirements in America because of the problems over there. There's also been a consistent demand by the vehicle manufacturers over here. Thirdly, I think that tyre manufacturers are required to produce a wide range and variety of tyres. And of course, the motorist is tending to keep his car longer.
And the range of tyres you stock at this depot, for example, how many would there be here?
Well, this is an exceptional station, but we stock approximately 4,000 car tyre units or car tyres here. And I would suggest that probably a figure nearer 1,500 or 2,000 is the figure that most people keep. But I would like to say that you can get an idea of the problem that we have. Is that if we stocked one set of tyres, that is five tyres of each type and size of one particular manufacturer, we would have over 1,000 tyres in stock. And multiply that by the number of makes, and you can see the kind of problems we have in stocking all types and sizes.
Wouldn't it be better if we were to limit, say, the size ranges to maybe half a dozen and make everyone put one of those tyres on their cars?
Would certainly be ideal for us. We would enjoy that sort of thing. And I think that in time this will happen. Currently there's a certain number of changes going through. We all know now about cross-ply tyres and fabric radial tyres and steel radial tyres. And I think that over the next few years we'll see a shift towards one type of tyre.
Perhaps the most sinister part of this story is that if motorists are finding it difficult to get hold of new tyres, what on earth are they driving around on at the moment?
Good question. We look at our offtake. Tyres that are taken away from the cars, and we reckon to see 25% of them below the legal limit.
Peter Miller's the foreman at this tyre depot, so he's well qualified to talk about the tyres some motorists are driving around on. Peter, where on earth did you find that?
This came off a Mini, sliding around in the wet weather. You can see there's totally nothing there at all, and there's no tread, so you can see why he was sliding.
And if you're caught with tyres like that?
Endorsement with each, plus a fine, plus your insurance is void.
So four possible endorsements with those?
All told.
And what about these two here?
Well, this is a textile brace. You can see that the person's worn it so far through the canvas that you can even put your finger through it. The one
and
below
this, what's
suffered from a puncture. You can see the steel
this
coming
the steel
through, and it's really cut your fingers to pieces on that. So there's another.
And were the motorists aware that their tyres were in this condition?
No at all. They just came in and said, well, I'm suffering from problems, and you can see from those why they were suffering from problems.
What about the problems that come with not having the tyres inflated to the right pressure?
Well, this is one where it's overinflated. The centre tread is totally gone, but the outside shoulders are all right. One below is where it's underinflated. Centre tread is all right, but the outside shoulder is totally gone again. So due to the lack of attention, they've lost a lot of mileage.
Because a tyre could look something like that when you've got tracking problems, couldn't it?
Yeah, there's an example over here where the tracking is so bad that the brand new tyre 2 months ago, it's run down and the inside edge has totally gone bald. So another tyre's been completely wasted.
Well, it's hard to believe that people are driving around with tyres like that and they don't know.
Well, here's one example of virtually a brand new tyre, plenty of tread, sound as you look from the outside, but you can see where it's blown out through lack of tension. If you looked after the tyre in the first place, this wouldn't have caused the problem.
Peter, how long has it taken you to make this collection?
About 2 days. This is just a minor sample of what we usually take off.
And one last question. With the current shortage, which car owners are going to have problems coming here to you?
Mainly the high performance cars like Mercedes and Porsche.
Roy, we've just heard from Peter about the situation here in London. What's the picture for the rest of the country like?
Well, in the southwest, the situation is that tyres such as 1-4-5-10 steel radials that fit the Mini are in short supply. In the north of England, the 13-inch fabric radial, like for the Cortina. And up in Scotland, the Marina size 1-4-5-13 fabric is in short supply.
So in general, from the expert, what's your advice to the motorists?
Well, I would suggest that the motorists contact the specialist. Any member of the National Tyre Distributors Association would be very happy for them to call on them for advice and free inspection. And it would be most helpful if all the motorists could give their favourite supplier 10 to 14 days' notice of their requirements.